We're back, baby. Guys, welcome back here to another episode on the channel here of Matt's Mind. I know it's been like 5 weeks, over a month since the last episode. I think it was week 11. So we've also grown a little bit. So if you guys are brand new to the series here on the channel, or if you're brand new to the channel overall, make sure you go ahead and click the subscribe button. But Matt's Mind is basically the Q&A series here on the channel I host every week. Now I've been inconsistent with the series, but it's okay. I've been busy, but obviously school is winding down. We're going to be able to go hard with the series every single week as promised. So if you guys have a question you'd like me to answer, definitely go ahead and comment it down below in the comment section. Of course, smash the like button. First question here today comes from TLegoBoy. Will you be building the ship of the Bad Batch? I saw a photo of it, and it looks a bit like Palpatine's shuttle from episode 3. It will be great to see it with the Naxxus. To answer your question, in all honesty, I don't know. One of my friends, Lee or Brick Builder Studios, some of you guys might know him on his Instagram and YouTube, he's actually in the middle of designing a Bad Batch shuttle, and he sent me a couple of pictures. I'm not going to share them, obviously, because that's his project. But it has been coming together pretty well as far as I know. He's still sort of working on the final tweaks and stuff like that. So in terms of me personally, I'm not good with ship designing. That's just not my thing. That's why I usually don't design any of the vehicles that are in my mocks. But if Lee does actually finalize it and it looks really good and it's actually buildable, I will definitely have no problem including that in my mock. I think it's a great sort of next level and like a really great addition to the mock overall. So that's sort of my plan for that. Next question here comes from LizzoLaura2988. How many ships will you have in your mock? Will it be customs or official sets? So none of the stuff in my mock is going to be an official set, except maybe for a Z, what is it, Z Headhunter, I think it was called, or just the Z-100 Headhunter from the Clone Wars. The idea is to have 2 gunships custom, 2 AT-TEs custom, 1 of the ARC-170s custom inside the base, and 1 of the Bad Batch shuttles. And I think there might be room for one more vehicle on the outside. I'm not too sure what's going to be exactly yet, but it's going to be looking anywhere between 5 or 6 vehicles in the entire mock, including gunships and like starships. Next question here comes from Arn Fortis. If you could design your own battle pack, what figures would you include and what would you select for the set? I'm assuming like you mean the actual build for the set. So as you guys know, with my project for Naxxus, getting phase 2 clones isn't necessarily the easiest, nor is it the most inexpensive way. I've had to order some custom stuff for the helmets and weapons. So I think the battle pack that I really like to see from LEGO is definitely got to be just a normal phase 2 clone battle pack. I'm not going to harp on the whole 501st thing, that's sort of run its course. But in terms of like an actual logistical battle pack that would be useful, I'd love to see like a Battlefront 2 style battle pack where we have 2 phase 2 regular white clones, maybe an Imperial officer, and then one other figure. And then for the build, we could have like a turret station or like a mini speeder bike. I do have to say, with the whole Return of the Clone Wars and all that kind of stuff, I do think we will get a battle pack like that sometime down the road. But in terms of stuff that I would really, really like right now, that's kind of got to be the battle pack that I really, really want. If I made this video before the whole 20th anniversary wave, I would have probably said that the new Stormtrooper mold, I would have loved a battle pack with those. But since we have a $20 set that comes with 4 of those new molds, and of course the Han Solo exclusive. This question here comes from First Order Lego. When can we expect the wizard to come to a European convention? I gotta be honest with you, I have no idea. I'm in no position financially to afford a $2,000, $1,000 flight to Europe and back, especially with the expenses. So maybe, I definitely do want to make it out to one of them in my lifetime, that's for sure. So I guess I'll keep posted on that, man. Next question here comes from Jace, and I'm not going to try and say that last name. Who is your favorite clone? Obviously, I'm assuming you're referring to like the named clones in the series and the saga, and maybe even the Clone Wars TV show. I think the one clone, and really the only clone, one of the only clones that you sort of form this sort of relationship with, at least in regards to the Clone Wars TV series, has to be Rex. You know, you know a lot about him. We know his loyalties to Anakin Skywalker, and he didn't partake in killing the Jedi and sort of, you know, doing all the bad stuff, so he kind of hitchhiked and got the hell out. So I gotta say, Captain Rex has probably gotta be my favorite clone, obviously just knowing a lot about his character, especially the fact that he was able to withstand, you know, the inhibitor chip and get it removed, and obviously be smart enough to not commit Order 66. I think Captain Rex is definitely gonna be my favorite, obviously seeing the relationship he has with Ahsoka, especially in the new Clone Wars Season 7 trailer. Holy crap. Or I think they're on I'm assuming they're on a Venator or any sort of ship, and then Ahsoka opens the door, and there are all the 501st troopers with the Ahsoka helmets on. I think that's just a good show of character. I usually love to get emotionally attached with characters, whether it be in Star Wars or like Game of Thrones or something. So in terms of that sort of emotional connection, I think Captain Rex is the best. Next question here comes from Enzal. Where do you indulge in studious activities such as studying math, science, history, other stuff like that? I'm assuming you're basically wondering how I have so much time to actually study and where I study. So believe it or not, I do put college first. That's just the brutal reality of where I'm at in my life. I would love to put YouTube first, but if/until YouTube starts to pay out more in terms of living expenses, we have to continue with school and stuff like that. But basically, I just make a to-do list, like literally with when the the week starts, I mean, I can't show you because my laptop's dead, but in my notes section, I literally put to-do this week, and I put Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, all the stuff I have to do every single day, and it does get overwhelming. Like, right now, the time I'm filming this video, I actually spent time writing one of three annotated essays I need to write, also reading 300 pages this week, so it's definitely a lot of work, but really, the best advice is just to make a section of whatever, write it down, type it up of stuff you need to do, and then make it basically like a checklist. So you think, okay, I have to do this. When I'm done, check. And you feel good. You feel like you've accomplished something. Lots and lots and lots of college students, especially myself, who are either working part-time jobs to pay off debts, or if they're just even doing YouTube or trying to pursue YouTube as a legitimate way of income and a career, it definitely gets overwhelming, and I've definitely been subjective to that for a couple of times now, but I think I've learned over time how to manage my time responsibly. So basically, whenever I have time for studious activities, it's obviously every single day. It's just kind of mixed in whatever I'm planning sort of throughout that day or that week, and it kind of varies, but I do have to set aside for it, obviously. Next question here comes from Hideous City. It's not Lego related, but what kind of music are you into? I pretty much dig anything except like old classical music. Rock music is okay. I'm more of a fan of like hip-hop, rap, R&B, stuff like that. But when it comes to music, like if we're hanging out in a car, hanging out at a convention center, I'm pretty much cool with anything unless it's like stupid goth music or like headbanger rock music or classical stuff. Next question here comes from Fremlin the Gremlin. Have you ever stolen a friend's Lego or stolen Lego in general? No. I don't think I've ever stolen a friend's Lego, nor has anyone stolen one of my Lego items or bricks. And if you have friends who are stealing them from you, they're bad friends. And if you're stealing it from your friends, you're a bad friend. Next question here comes from Mix the Bricks. He says, do you know Darth Maul appears in Solo? Yes. If yes, do you think he will appear in Star Wars Episode 9? I hope to God no, if I'm being completely honest. Like, him in Solo was kind of cool for me. I know there's a lot of mixed feelings about that. But if Darth Maul has no place in Episode 9. He really doesn't. There's no point for him in terms of plot convenience or even really fan convenience or fan sort of privilege and like just satisfying the fans. That Darth Maul has no place being in Episode 9. I'll be flat out right with you right here. If he does appear in Episode 9, I'll be really disappointed because in my opinion, unless they link him into some magnificent plot twist that's really just epic. Next question here comes from Rebo Bricks. As far as entertaining movies go, do you enjoy Star Wars or Marvel movies better? I gotta say Star Wars. I love Star Wars. I will always love Star Wars, but Marvel is like right there. Like if Star Wars was here, Marvel is literally like right there. It's just a hair below. In recent times, I've actually experienced a lot of the new Marvel movies in theaters. Obviously, like I've been saying, the three biggest cinematic experiences for me all came within the past couple of years. Third has definitely got to be the Rogue One scene, right, where Vader is just absolutely destroying all the Rebel Troopers. The second best has to be Thor arriving on Wakanda, and I literally get chills every time I watch that part of the movie. And the first one has to be seeing the opening crawl of The Force Awakens, right, because that was really the first Star Wars movie that I like vividly remember seeing in a movie theater, especially obviously because I was really young when the prequels came out. So I think that's that. But so Star Wars does like top it, but Marvel is really, really close second. So a little bit of a shorter Matt's Mind episode today, guys. I hope you all understand. Of course, let's go ahead and get back into the swing of things. I know we missed a couple of weeks, but like I said before, be sure to comment your questions down below, and I will definitely get back to you on those in the following week. Make sure you stay tuned tomorrow for a Should You Buy. We'll be talking about this wonderful, wonderful Vader bust here. And we'll be going in depth with this bad boy. And of course, Friday at 2 p.m., I will be doing a live stream of building an Axis in Lego. It's gonna be lit, it's gonna be wild. Make sure you guys stay tuned. Make sure you all have post notifications on, and I'll see you later. Peace.